Good morning from the Union Buildings, an iconic landmark in Pretoria and South Africa in general. It is a popular tourist attraction as well as an emblem of democracy. It is also a South African National Heritage Site. June has seen a lot of yoga celebrations this month all around the country, and today we celebrate it with the High Commission of India in Pretoria. This event is proudly sponsored by Dentons, Momentum Metropolitan, VFS Global, Satguru, Andal Foods, Heartfulness, Titans, Geet, The Travel Boss, Thirsty, Taj Hotels South Africa, and Amphitech. Joining me this morning is Captain Atul Sipaya, who is the defense advisor to our High Commissioner. And he's going to tell us how yoga enhances his lifestyle. Good morning, sir, and welcome.
Very good morning to you, and it's a privilege to be here today this morning at Union Grounds and this event, which is being organized by High Commission of India at Pretoria. As we all know, yoga has multifold benefits. It keeps us physically fit, mentally strong, and helps us to synchronize our mind with our body and also the soul. So it has multiple benefits, and being from Navy, we have practiced, and still, as you are aware, more than 19 ships are forming an ocean ring of yoga all over the world, and taking this yoga, which is a truly heritage of India, to the entire world globally, and helping everyone to keep that balance of fitness, both for the body and the mind. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your input, and we appreciate your service to the Indian mission.
Thank you.
With us this morning is Ms. Anuradha Negi, who is the head of chancery for the High Commission of India, and she's going to tell us how yoga enhances her lifestyle. Good morning.
Good morning, everyone. We are all assembled here to celebrate International Yoga Day today at the Union Building Lawn in South in Africa, in Pretoria. And today, the International Day of Yoga is being celebrated at the High Commission of India. And the theme for the yoga, International Yoga this year is Vasudev Kutumba. That the whole world is a big family, and we are all. And the main purpose of yoga is to increase the strength, flexibility of the body. And taking deep breath, holding breath, and the posture increases the overall health of a person. So all over the world, India has given everyone how to celebrate yoga. The world the benefits of yoga, and we are all here to celebrate yoga every day. Thank you, everyone, and welcome to all for celebrating International Day of Yoga.
Thank you so much, ma'am. As you can see, the ambience behind us is now getting very energetic and invigorating. So, sticking with the theme of Vasudeva Kutumbakam, we have yoga for harmony and peace. And joining us is Shaswati Das, who is a practicing yogi as well as a dancer. Good morning, welcome. Please tell me, I'm well, thank you. Please tell me, how does yoga enhance your life as a dancer, and how do you implement dancing and yoga just to ground yourself?
For dance and for yoga, we in both case we need the balancing. So yoga helped me a lot for keep me calm down and do the balancing properly. And parallelly, when I am on stage with all the other participants, because normally I work nearly with the 40 people, 30 people like that, so it's make me very calm and quiet in the rehearsal period, and when on stage also it's make me pleasure to submit everybody at home.
Thank you. I'm going to catch you on the spot. So are you going to give me a yoga dance pose? That's fantastic. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you. Good morning and namaste to everyone. I, Aman Gulia, extend a very warm welcome and my sincere gratitude to all of you who have come today to celebrate the 9th International Day of Yoga. Today, we have gathered here in front of the Union Buildings, the place where Nelson Mandela was inaugurated as the first democratically elected president. There could be no other place better than this to celebrate this occasion. Yoga comprises of various asanas or postures which help us in improving physical and mental strength, relieving stress, increasing body awareness, and has also proven to cure many chronic diseases. Now, I would like to request Mr. Devendra Kumar, Charge DFAS High Commission of India, to come and say a few words on this occasion.
Namaste, good morning, dear dignitaries, member of diplomatic committee, ladies, gentlemen, friends of India. It is with great pleasure we welcome you all at the 9th International Day of Yoga celebration. The draft regulation establishing the International Day of Yoga was proposed by India and endorsed by a record 175 member states. The proposal was first introduced by Prime Minister Narendra Modi in his address during the opening of the 69th session of the General Assembly, in which he said, "Yoga is an invaluable gift from our ancient tradition. The benefit of yoga for physical and mental health are well known. Today, gathering the celebration is the reiteration of this well-known fact. I am very happy that so many international South African and Indian friends have joined us today to celebrate this important declaration of the United Nations 21st June as the International Day of Yoga. This year's theme for the yoga is Vasudev Kutumbakam, means the world is one family. Through yoga, we want to spread peace and happiness in the world. We want people to live like one big family. Celebration of International Day of Yoga is our humble effort to unite the people of the world. I have prayer for you all. May all be happy and healthy. May all be free from illness. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. There are various styles of yoga, and one of them is yoga nritya, that is yoga dance. As the name suggests, yoga dance combines yoga with dance. In this yoga, yogis perform asanas in rhythm with the music. Yoga dance is a creative form of yoga that can be practiced by yogis of all ages and offer countless benefits. Now, I would like to invite Ms. Saraswati Das and her students who will demonstrate a yoga dance. Everyone is encouraged to join with them.
Oh, Oh,
Thank you very much for such a wonderful yoga dance. We will now proceed with yoga demonstrations by Shiva Yoga Studio, Mr. Ravi and Ms. Bev. These yogis will perform the basic yoga asanas.
Namaste everybody. We're going to be teaching the class today. And on behalf of my fellow teachers, I've got Bev on my left and Leanne on my right. We know that you've done a session already. That was supposed to be a dance, but now we're going to ask everyone to join us in this session, right? So everybody's got to do this one. Let's start by sitting down cross-legged. You can place your hands on your knees. Oh, sorry, my name is Ravi. I always forget to introduce myself. Okay, so you're going to sit tall. So lean into the back, lift into the crown, close your eyes. We're going to start with three ohms. Now, if you're not comfortable with the ohms, just sit quietly. If you want to chant along with us, you can go for it. We're going to do it in a different style, taking the hands to the sides, using the breath and the arms. So if you don't want to do the ohms, you can just do the arm work and the breath work. Hands to the sides, open up the chest. Inhale the arms up, big stretch. Hook the thumbs, stretch up, pull apart, palms facing down. Oh. In, hook, hold, stretch up, pull apart. Oh. Last one, in. This one you're going to hold for a short while. Hold the breath. Sitting quietly, close your eyes. Just feel the vibration of the sound. Keep your eyes closed. We're going to go into some Vitri breathing, which is the square breath or the equal-sided breath. So what this means, you're going to do a square meaning four sides, right? All four sides are equal. We're going to start with an easy count of five. So we'll start to breathe in for five. We're going to hold for five, exhale for five, pause for five. Ready? Long spine. Squeeze the shoulders together. Let's open up the chest. Hands softly placed on the knees. All the breathing through the nose, unless we tell you otherwise. Breathe in to the nose, breathe out to the nose. Next round, breathing in. One, two, three, four, five. Hold the breath. One, two, three, four, five. Exhale. One, two, three, four, five. Pause. One, two, three, four, five. In. One, two, three, four, five. Hold. One, two, three, four, five. Exhale. One, two, three, four, five. Pause. One, two, three, four, five. Keep going now. It's a 5 second in. Five count in. Hold. Sorry. Breathe in. Hold. Exhale. Pause. Right. Four sides, all equal. Keep a 5 count going. As you keep going with this, I'll just speak to you very quickly. So this breath, the square breath, a Samavitri breath, is an equal breath. So it focuses on all sides of the oxygen intake and exchange and hold. Has profound effect on the mind, right? Helps to release stress, tension, keeps... So the beauty of this particular breath is that it helps us to stay focused yet relaxed. So you could use it in any circumstance. We've recently heard that a lot of the US Marines and soldiers use this breath. So the reason they use this breath is that it keeps them focused, so they have acute attention, but at the same time the nervous system is completely relaxed. So keep going. Five, in, hold, exhale, pause. Okay, on the next round, as you get your next exhale, I want you to squeeze out, hold, exhale, pause, return the breath to normal. So finish your round, right? Finish the round, return the breath to normal. We're going to take an inhale, big one, inhale through the nose and sigh out with sound. Okay, you can open the eyes. You're still sitting still and sitting tall, hands on the knees, loosely placed on the hands, on the knees rather. Lift through the crown. We're going to work slightly into the neck. Now, if you have neck injuries, just take it very easy. At the same time, I think in yoga, what we always advocate is always listen to the body, right? The body is your guide. The minute you're feeling pain, you've gone too far, rather just pull back a little bit. Reach up to the crown. Just some easy neck movements. So from here, drop your chin towards your throat and feel as if you got that length in the neck. Now, as you inhale, lift the head up and look at the back. Stretch up. Inhale. Exhale, squeeze down. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, squeeze down. Last one, inhale, up. When you're done with this, I want you to center the head. Keep your spine long. We're going to go right to left. Now, the breath work here. You breathe into center, you exhale to side. You breathe into center, exhale, ready. Inhale, exhale, turn your head over to the right side. Try to get the chin over the shoulder. Bring it in, inhale, exhale, left side. Inhale, exhale, right side. Inhale, exhale, left side. Inhale, exhale, right side. Inhale, exhale, left side, and center. Take a breath there. You can relax the shoulders. Take a breath here. Shoulders. We're going to do some shoulder rolls. So we're going to bring our fingers to the top of the shoulder and bring the elbows together. It's a big movement. It's going to open up the shoulder and the neck muscles here. So from here, as you inhale, lift the elbows up, stretch up, lengthen up, a big movement going back, stretch back. And bring it down, let the elbows touch. We're going to integrate with breath now, so inhale up. As you go back, exhale. One more, inhale up. Exhale down. Let the elbows touch, and we're going to reverse this posture. So we're going back, inhale. Bring it up, elbows touch. Exhale. Inhale up. Big movement. Exhale. Inhale up. Elbows touch. Exhale and relax. Hands on the knees. Take a breather. Rest. Feel. Side to side. So, firstly, there's something that we need to know. If a lot of us work in the office situation, we're always looking at a screen. So a lot of us getting this, what they're now calling a tech neck, right? So all of these muscles are getting tight in the shoulders and the neck. So these two asanas that we just done now would open up that structure in terms of the tightness in the shoulders and the neck. So this one, hands to the sides, inhale, bring the arms up, palms together on top. You're gonna lengthen up to the fingers, inhale. On the exhale, drop the whole body over to the right. Now don't lift the buttocks off the floor. You're going opposite to me, right? Inhale up, exhale left. Inhale up, exhale right. Inhale up, exhale left. Inhale up, exhale right. Inhale up, exhale left. Inhale up. And release the hands soft onto the knees. Take a breather, rest, feel. You can extend the legs and then bring soles of feet together. Interlock the fingers around the toes. And if you come to try to bring the heels in close, close, close to the body. as close as you can get it, right? Remember, no pain. You should be just at the point where you get that good stretch. Long spine, I want the flat back. Look forward and start to just flex the knees up and down. So this is called butterfly. Yeah? You're thinking that the legs are the wings of the butterfly? The intention here is to try it, it might not touch, but you want to get the back of the legs as far to the mat as you can get it. At the same time, you're lifting as high as you can. Flat back, look forward. Oh, so during this class, we want all of us on stage, we want you to do three things for us. One, you have to smile. It doesn't matter what kind of yoga you asana you're doing, right? Or pose you're doing. You have to smile. Second, you're going to breathe deeply through the nose. Only through the nose, right? And it's deep breaths right into the core of your body. And then thirdly, in yoga we call we got something called drishti, or point of focus or awareness. So you're going to pick anything. It doesn't, and it'll keep moving. Your drishti will keep moving. It could be now your finger, now your toe, now something on the grass, something on your mat. It doesn't matter what it is, but you keep something at your drishti. Relax, release. Hands to the sides, assist the knees, bring it up, extend the legs. You can, if you want, you can wobble the legs, just to give it a loosen. Cross legs again. We're going to stretch now, bro. What's next? Robot. Okay, sorry, extend the legs. My fault. That. Okay, we're going to keep the feet together, rowing the boat. So this one here, you're going to flex the toes. So the toes are facing up towards your face. You lock your legs out. Knees are locked. And you try, your look, the heels will move on the mat, but you're going to try and keep the feet on the floor as much as you can. The idea here is called rowing the boat. So like you take two oars in your hands, hold it. You're going to bring it up, take it down, bring it up again, right? But with that comes the lean onto the back, and this is where we start to work on the core and the back muscles, so we strengthen all these muscles here. So take the hands like you're holding oars, thumbs on the inside right next to your hip. I'm going to guide you first on the first one without the breath, then the second one we're going to do it with the breath, right? So from here, start to lean forward and extend the hands forward, big stretch, and then lift up, inhale all the way up, and now start to lean the back. Tighten the core. Lean as much as you can go, and then bring it down, side of hip, and float it down. You got it. Inhale. Inhale, 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 inhale. As you go back, exhale, bring it down. That's two. Inhale, up. Stretch up. Exhale, down. I stretch in the arms, right? Bring it up. Sit. Bring the hands to the size of the hip. We're going to reverse this movement. So you're going to lean back on an inhale. Reach up. Exhale, float forward. Inhale. Bring it up. Lean into the back. Lean into the back. Exhale, float forward. Last one. Inhale up. And exhale forward. Bring it to the hip again, and you can separate the feet, relax the legs, and start to take your feet wide. So you can go right to the edge of the mat. If you're comfortable, you can go off the mat, right? Dynamic spinal twist, feet are facing up to the ceiling. This floor is hot. Arms to the sides, upright. So here, you want to keep this integrity of the spine, so you're going to keep it long. So it's not about going forward and trying to touch a toe. What you want to focus on is this part of the body, right? The spine. So arms up, inhale. Right hand to left foot, inhale. Exhale. Just take it over. You don't have to touch. Inhale, center. Exhale, twist. Now, as you do this, I want you to integrate the head. So bring it to center. Inhale, exhale. Right hand to left foot. Look at the back hand. Inhale. Exhale. Look at the right hand. Inhale. Exhale. Look at the left hand. Inhale, exhale, look at the right hand. Inhale, exhale, release. Bring the feet back in onto your mat. You can sit in base for a short while. Just take the fingers facing away. Long spine, take a breather, rest, feel. Full forward stretch, you're going to bring your feet together. If you're comfortable, if you're feeling you're sitting on your hip bone, so in yoga we got something called the sitting bone, right? It's the same hip bone. If you're comfortable, you can stay there. Otherwise, you're going to lift the hip up and plant yourself back. And you find that when you sit now, you have more space to move forward, right? Flex the toes. Inhale the arms up. Reach up to the ceiling. I want you to, reach to the sky, sorry. Reach, right up to the sky. No length. Before you do a full forward stretch, what you should do is lengthen the spine. So reach up more. Feel as if your whole spine is getting longer. Inhale. On the exhale, soften the tummy and hinge from the hip and fold. You can go to shin, ankle, back of feet. Doesn't matter where you go, but keep the knees locked and look forward, look up, flat back. It's not about getting the knees to the head to the knee. Just keep it here, stay. I'm going to count 4, 9, right? Soften. Deep breaths to the nose, keep your smile on, keep your point of focus, your drishti. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Inhale, lift. Exhale, release, separate the feet, and again, sit in base, but again, sit soft knees, take a breather, rest, feel. Breathe to the nose. Inhale. I want a sighing breath. Big one with sound, right? Inhale. Side out. Cross legs. Hands to floor. Walk onto your knees and come up into what we call tabletop. So tabletop, your body resembles that of a table. So that's not me. That's the wind. So your wrist is directly under the shoulder, the knees are underneath the hips. Your feet are in line with your knee, okay? Flat back, reach to the crown, inhale. On the exhale, draw your chin towards your throat, lift the body up and draw the tummy back. As you feel the rounding, exhale, hold the exhale, 1, 2, 3, inhale. Arch the spine, don't move your hands or your legs. They stay stable, it's only the trunk and the head. In the neck, lift up, feel the arch in the spine, 1, hold the breath, 2, 3, exhale, squeeze down, chin to throat, lift the body, draw the tummy back, hold, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, inhale, arch the spine, you gotta wait for me, right, don't preempt the moves, stay, look up, stay, feel the arch in the spine, hold the breath, 2, 3, 4, 5, you're going for 7, squeeze down, draw the tummy back, lift, hold, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, arch the spine, lift up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, flat back, relax now, relax the arms, relax the legs, take a breather, step your hands one step forward, curl the toes under, we're gonna lift up into downward facing dog, Adho Mukha Svanasana. From here, lift the knees up and come up into down dog. So in down dog, you press your head down as far as you can towards the mat, extend into the fingers, keep the arms locked, press into the legs and try to get the heels to the mat. Don't worry if you don't get the heels down now, but press into the heels and feel your knees lock out. At the same time, pull the tummy back, activate your mudra here, stay, deep breaths. Hold it. Deep breath into nose, into tummy. Only 5 here, right? Into nose, into tummy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Slowly, gently relax the body. Slowly start to walk your feet to center of mat. Center of mat. Dip the body in. Bend your knees. Roll the body up. Come to stand. Slowly up. We're standing in what you call Tadasana, the mountain pose. So you're going to stand with your feet shoulder-width distance, hands to the sides, open up the chest. So if you feel your blood pressure is not regulated, just take a moment. Just stand, take a breather, rest, feel. Once the pressure is regulated, I want you to start to engage Tadasana. So you're going to spread the toes, create a grip onto the mat. Lock the knees out, tighten up your thighs, your calves, your core, your lower back. Press the hands to the side, not touching, but just pressing the shoulders back and locking the arms. Chin up, take a breather here. Stay, 1. This is called mountain pose, right? Tadasana. You want to feel as if you are strong as a mountain. Nothing can disturb you, right? Stay, breathe. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Inhale, exhale, relax. Relax the knees, relax the body, stand, take a breather. So very important now as you're going to balance is to keep your point of focus, your drishti, right? We spoke about this before. So anything, it could be a corner of your mat, some other point that you want to focus on as your point of focus or your drishti. So you're going to stand on the right foot. You're going to do Vrksasana tree balance. Tree balance. Spread the toes, nice grip, soft knee. I'm going to give you a couple of options here. Okay, so firstly, yoga is about unity, right? We all united as one family. So I want us to put this into action today. If you find somebody that's next to you that's doing balance but they're dancing all over the place, can you just lend a hand out so that they can balance, right? Let's try. If you find the full tree balance a bit of a challenge, then you've got a couple of options. One, you can place the heel just onto the ankle and you can lift up and stand. That's fine. Okay, you're still doing your balance. Or you can take it on the calf. Or you take it above the knee, but not onto the knee. Not here. It's always below the knee or above the knee. Okay. Are we ready? Let's try. You're going to hold for 9 count. Or should I give you 5 count? If his balance is good. Nobody's smiling. I don't know what's happened. We started with the smile and then after this came to balance, nobody was, okay, smile. So pick your point of focus, right? Spread the toes. Now gently, don't move your eyes off your focal point and bring your left leg up, either ankle, calf or thigh. If you have it on the thigh, try and check that the knee is in line with the shoulder. Then take the hands to the sides of the body, inhale the arms up. Reach up, reach up, reach up, reach up. As you reach into this towards the ceiling, towards the sky again, get the palms together, keep your focus. 1. Going for 9. 2. 3. 4. 5. 6. 7. 8. 9. Now the same way you came up softly, right? Relax the hand slowly down, control. And slowly control, release the leg. Release the leg slowly down. Control. Take a moment, close your eyes, feel what does the right side balance feel like versus the left side. Open your eyes. Again, pick your point of focus. It could be the same point that you're focusing on, right? Keep your point of focus. Left foot, spread the toes. Now, right leg, ankle, calf, thigh. Wherever you go, check that the knee is in line with the shoulder, hands to the sides, inhale up. Stay focused, stay focused. Reach up to the sky, pressure onto the hands. Stay. 1. Steady, steady, steady. 2. 3. 4. 5. 6. 7. 8. 9. Inhale, release the hands first. Slowly down, control. Then gently release the leg. Control, stand. Stand tall, close your eyes. And just feel the effect of balance. So every asana we do in yoga has some effect on the system, right? And it's also teaching us some lesson. So with balance, let's ask the question. Close your eyes and just stay comfortable here. What is this balance pose teaching me? Am I balanced with my diet? Am I balanced with my sleep patterns? Am I sleeping 7 to 8 hours? Am I eating more of the green stuff, right? The more plant-based foods, because you know this is good for us, right? Is my work-life balance situation, do I have a balance there? What's my financial balance like? What's my emotional balance like? How's my yoga balance? Do I do yoga? Do I do meditation? So all of these things will factor into your life. You have to bring it in, create some sort of balance so you can use all these tools to help us in this journey of life. Slowly open the eyes. Okay, we're going to move into sun salutation, Surya Namaskar. The first round is right and left side. We're going to take it very slow, very easy, just give you an idea of what this is about. And in the second round, we're going to start to move with a little bit of speed. I'll integrate then the breath there. And then the third round, I want you to kind of at least take away something from this practice that you could use on your own, right? So Surya Namaskar is going to be the one, okay? Yeah, we can learn it in this session. Feet together. If you can get the toes to touch, get the toes to touch. If you can get the heels to touch, let the heels touch. Spread the toes, create a grip. I want you to lock up, lock up, lock up, lock up. Feel all those muscles are working. Don't stand casually here. Pressure onto the hands, thumbs to chest. Bend the thumbs, let the thumbs touch the Anahata chakra. As you press into your hands, I want your shoulders to roll back. Lift to the crown, close your eyes. Beautiful sunny day. Start to focus on this big ball of energy, the sun. Bring it to the space between the eyebrows. Feel this energy float all the way down into the solar plexus. From here into the legs, hands, the body. Feel this energy heal the body, energize the body. Stay with that visualization. Send a small prayer of gratitude to the sun. Thank the sun for all the energy sent to the earth for sustenance. Remember, if there's no sun, the earth would die, and all of us on this planet will die, right? So sun is a very important component of life on planet earth, and we need this. So we send some gratitude. This whole practice of Surya Namaskar is a gratitude practice to the sun. Are we ready? Slowly, gently, inhale. So don't worry too much about the breathing just yet. Just get the postures right. Lift the arms up, pressure right to the top, all the way up, open up, fingers together. Then as you reach up to the sky, create a back bend. Look up at the sea, at the sky, float forward. Hands to floor, slowly. Legs are locked, right? Doesn't matter if you can't get the fingers to the mat, I want you to keep this legs locked and give it a big stretch as you dip down, head down. Then lift the head, bend the knees, right leg back. Big stretch. Right back, drop the knee. Now your toes are still engaged on the left. Take your pointer fingers in line, spread the fingers and look up into equestrian. And then step back into downward dog. Now slowly take the left leg back. Feet together at the back. The same way you started at front, right? Dip the head, pull the tummy back, activate your Anahata chakra. Stay, pull, press the heels down, stay. Now from here, slowly, gently drop your knees first. Eight limbs, this is called eight limbs. Knees, chest, chin, eight parts of body on the floor. Now your hip is up, yeah? Stay there for a short while, push the body forward, flatten. Then slowly, gently hug the elbows against the ribs and lift slowly up into Bhujanga. You go as far as you can. Just listen to the body, right? Push back, down dog. Settle into down dog, dip the head, pull the tummy, press the heels. Your drishti here, I'll just give you an example, right? Now you're looking down, you should be looking at your knees, that's your point of focus. Each asana will move your point of focus. Lift the head up, take the left leg forward, step it all the way forward, right in line with your fingers, drop the right knee, look up equestrian. Step, feet together, toes touch, heels touch if you can. Arms to sides of the ears lift, one single motion coming up. Reach up, back bend, look up at the sky, pressure on, coming down. I'm sorry, I teach in a room, so it's always about the ceiling. So this is the sky is my ceiling today. Pressure on, left side, yeah? Same thing. Are we okay? Is there anything? Everybody okay? Inhale, arms up, pressure on, lift, 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 lift. Reach up to the ceiling, separate, sorry, sky, back bend. Fold hands to floor. Keep your legs locked. I want that stretch in the legs, right? Keep it down. Dip down. As far as you can go. Now bend the knee. Soften. Take the left leg back. Slowly down. Drop the knee. Look up equestrian. Step back slowly with the right leg. Your feet together at the back. Dip. Press down. Dip the head. Pull the tummy back. Press the heels as far as you can go. Same thing with the down dog before, right? Knees. Chest, chin, eight parts of body on the floor. Hug the elbows in. Feel that hip lift. Then flatten the body and lift into Bhujanga. Cobra pose. Curl, push back, down dog. Settle. Focus. Now, right leg comes forward. Apologies, right leg. Step left leg forward. Inhale, arms alongside the ears, lift. Okay, so the next two rounds, or next round rather, right and left, we're going to focus on the breath, right? Back stretch, pressure on, coming down. Now we synchronize breath all through the nose. Ready? Inhale. Little bit quicker. Exhale. Right leg, inhale up into equestrian. Exhale, down dog. So exhale, continue the exhale as you go into eight limbs. Hug elbows in. Inhale, up. Exhale, down dog. Left side, inhale, up. Exhale. Inhale, arms alongside the ears, lift. Reach up, back bend. Pressure on, coming down. You guys are doing so well. Awesome, keep it up. Inhale, up. Focus on breathing right through the nose. Exhale, fold. Lift. Inhale, up. Exhale, down. Same exhale all the way down. Eight parts of body on the floor. Inhale, up. Exhale, down. Right leg, inhale, up. Exhale, down. In. Now, can we keep the momentum going? Just keep the rhythm going, right? A little more quicker now. In. Out. Right. Down. Eight. Cobra. Down. Left. Are you smiling? Are we breathing through the nose? In. Have you got your point of focus? In. Out. Left. Down. Eight. Cobra. Down. Right. Head to knee. In. Out. And let's stop. Let's take a breather. I'll push you a bit there. Stay. Feet shoulder width distance. Hands to the sides. Take a breather. Rest. Feel. Connect. Just stand, breathe. I want you to take five breaths into nose, into tummy here, right? One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Slowly, gently. We're going to go into a squat. And then you're going to go lie down for just a minute, just to relax the body completely. So if you're not at the center of the mat, make your way to the center of the mat. Take your feet at an angle. So the feet are right at the edge of the mat, but at an angle. The reason you want to be at an angle is that the knees are going to go in this direction of the feet. Okay. This is called Malasana or Garland pose. You're going to bring the hands together, palms together. Elbows in. Now if you can't sit in the squat, right, your option here is to get the hands down to the floor and just push back as far as you can. If you go halfway, it's fine. You sit there and then after that you can sit down on the bum itself, okay? But don't, if you've never done a squat, don't do it now. You're gonna hurt yourself. Okay, pressure on, inhale. On the exhale, slowly down, start to push the bum back. Sink the hips down, deep down. Sink. And then slowly get the thumbs to center of chest as the triceps push the knees open and flatten the back, look up, stay, one. Smile, two. Deep breaths, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. You can assist the body, you can relax the hands here, bring the hands to the back of the body and then sit the bum back, extend the legs. Roll the body forward. Slowly, gently release the body down to the mat. Just a minute. Just relax, release. After your sun salutation, just rest. Stay. Breathe through the nose. Feet apart, hands away, palms facing up. Breathe through your nose. Connect. You might feel your heart rate is a little bit high. That's fine. Stay with that. But breathe gently through the nose. Don't change your breath. So traditionally, we do 12 rounds of sun salutation. We've done 6 today, right? So if you haven't done it before, this would be the practice that you want to do on a daily basis because this stretches everything in the whole system. Besides that, you're also building arm strength, leg strength, core strength. You're giving yourself a nice back bend, a forward bend. So all most of the asanas are in, except for a side bend and a balance. You can add that two, and if you want to twist, then you can give a twist in there. So three asanas in, and you've got a full yoga practice. Just stay, breathe. Okay, sighing breath. Inhale through the nose. Big one side out. From where you're lying down, bring your feet together, knees into chest, roll to the right hand side. I want you to stay there for a moment, pause, then come up to sit. You can assist the body, cross legs. Sit tall. Hands on the knees again. Take a breather here. Reach to the crown, lean into the back. So a lot of us sit, we sit with a lean forward, right? I want you to lean into the back, lift to the crown, feel the length, feel that spine open up. Relax the hands and the knees. Take a breather here. So we're going to end with a breath work and then a Shanti Mantra or Asatoma. If you know it, you can chant with me with this one, right? Well, before we end, I just want to thank you for practicing. Thank you firstly for coming out in your numbers. We really appreciate your attendance. And thank you for practicing with me today and with Bev and Leanne. I want to do a 1-to-2 ratio breathing. So the breath works that we're giving you is something that you can take away. It's easy breathing exercise you can do. So it's called pranayam. You can take it away and you can use it at any point you want to use it. A 1-to-2 ratio breathing is a simple breath technique, has a profound effect on the central nervous system, just relaxes all the stress and tension in your body. So the way it works, that you breathe in for a specific number, let's say 5, you're gonna exhale for that number, you double that number and exhale, so you're gonna exhale for 10. Are we ready? It sounds a lot, but it's not. Okay, sit tall, long spine. Let's just press the shoulders together. I want the openness in the chest, open up the lungs, right? Inhale through the nose. Exhale through the nose. Next round, I'm counting to 5. Breathing in slowly in through the nose. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale for 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. In for 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Out for 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Keep going. You got this now. You breathe in for 5, all through the nose. You exhale through the nose for 10. Never underestimate the simplicity of this breath, right? In yoga, we have an emphasis on the longer exhales. So inhale is important, but the exhale is critically important for us. Because the longer the exhale, the greater the benefit to the system, the whole system. So keep going. And as you get used to this practice in your own time, if you're practicing, you can then start to increase the count. So you can go 7, 14. You can go 10, 20, right? So you can continue increasing, but slowly. No straining. You got to go slowly over weeks and then over months to build up to a good longer number. You done. Finish on this next exhale. Keep your eyes closed. Deep breath into the nose. We're going to the Asatoma. You can chant with me if you know it.
Asato ma sadgamaya tamaso ma jyotirgamaya mrityor ma amritam gamaya om shanti shanti shanti.
Peace to the body, peace to the mind, peace to the soul. Hari Om Tat Sat. Thanks everyone.
Thank you very much for the amazing session. One of the key components of yoga is meditation. which has become very important to be calm and relaxed in this fast-moving life. To conclude the event, we will now practice yoga meditation led by Mr. Dion Padia.
Namaste. Good morning, dear sisters and brothers. Yoga and meditation are now mainstream ideas, with more research being done on their benefits every day. The specialty of heartfulness meditation is yogic transmission, which supports a deep meditative practice, a balanced life, peace of mind, and rapid personal transformation. You will come to feel the lightness and joy of your true nature in your heart, and when you listen to those feelings and capture the inspiration that comes from within, you will be able to master your life by being in tune with the heart. Through this exercise of fine-tuning the heart with the mind, your inner qualities will be refined and your potential will shine forth. Without further ado, let me explain what we're going to be doing today. So I will take you through a short guided relaxation followed by a short meditation. As I mentioned, the relaxation will be guided. I will talk you through it. When I finish the relaxation, I'll say, please start meditation. At this point, what we're going to do is make a gentle suggestion that there is a source of divine light illuminating our heart. And we try and have this feeling. It's not about concentration. It's about having this feeling that there's this source of divine light illuminating your heart. You can allow yourself to go inward. If there are any thoughts that come and trouble you, it's normal. All we do is we treat them as uninvited guests and gently bring your focus back to that source of divine light in your heart. We'll do that when I say, please start meditation. Once we are done, I will gently bring you out of the meditation in a guided way as well. So let's begin. Gently close your eyes. Sit in a very comfortable, relaxed position. Calm your mind. Breathe slowly and slowly start tuning in and centering yourself. We're going to begin the relaxation by focusing on our toes. So gently wiggle your toes and relax your toes. Feel the healing energy of the earth entering your being from your feet. Allow the energy to gently ascend through your legs, starting at your feet, your ankles, up towards your knees. As this healing energy is moving upwards, your legs are feeling completely relaxed. Allow the healing energy to gently move upwards towards your hips, relaxing your thighs, your hamstrings, and both of your legs. Both of your legs are completely relaxed. Now let's gently bring our focus to our stomach muscles. Allow the healing energy to gently move there, relaxing our stomach muscles. The healing energy is gently moving through our lower back, upper back. Our entire back is completely relaxed. feel the healing energy circulating around our chest. Our entire body, from our upper back and chest all the way down to our toes, are completely relaxed. Gently bring our focus to our shoulders. Feel the stress melting away. Our shoulders are becoming very light. Allow the healing energy to flow down our arms, upper arms, lower arms, palms, wrists, and fingers. Both our arms are completely relaxed. Take a deep breath in and out. Let's gently bring our focus to our neck. Consciously relax your neck. Allow the healing energy to move up to your neck, your jaw bones, your cheeks, nose, lips, ears, earlobes, forehead and temple. Your face is completely relaxed. Allow the healing energy to go around your head as well, your back of your head, top of your head. Your entire head is completely relaxed. Feel a gentleness and a lightness in your eyes. Your brain feels rested. Your mind is calm. Your body is completely relaxed from the top of your head to the bottom of your feet. Now, in this relaxed mode, gently bring your focus to your heart and make a suggestion that there's a source of divine light illuminating your heart from within. Let's remain here for a few moments. Please start meditation. Thank you. Let's remain with our eyes closed. Gently bring our focus back to our body. Try and connect with this feeling that you have now after these few minutes of meditation. If possible, store this feeling in your memory. And if need be, refer back to this feeling throughout the rest of the day. Please stop meditation. You can gently open your eyes when you are ready. Thank you very much. If you're interested in finding out about more about heartfulness meditation, please come through and visit our stall to my right hand side. It is free of charge and available to every single one of you. All are welcome. Thank you. Namaste.
Thank you so much for such a beautiful yoga meditation. We trust that everyone enjoyed the yoga sessions today. We would like to again thank Ms. Saswati, Mr. Umang, Mr. Ravi, Ms. Bev, Ms. Liana and Mr. Dion. Please give them a huge round of applause. Our sincere thanks also goes out to our sponsors, Momentum Metropolitan, Dentons, VFS Global, Sadhguru Travel, Andal Foods, Titans, Geet, Heartfulness, Amphatech, Taj Hotels, Thirsty Water, Travel Boss, Ms. Shamin, and volunteers from BAPS Swaminarayan Temple. Please also give them a huge round of applause. A big thanks to all of you as well who joined us today to celebrate the 9th International Day of Yoga. Please do join us for light snacks, and everyone may take the yoga mat and water bottles along with them. Thank you. Namaste.